Jonathan, you are so intolerant. You are chemtrail. And you? You are glyphosate intolerant. You are and you are aspartame intolerant. Are you soy intolerant? Yes. And you're barium intolerant. And you're histamine intolerant. And you're soy lecithin intolerant. Hello, we are happy to finally be able to make a video. Welcome to the Matrixers with the wonderful Jonathan and the attractive one Shiva. We have a very special topic for you today, and we have the topic: one or the other knows Robert Monroe, and he discovered something on one of his out-of-body experiences. And the topic is Lusch, right? After all, he has traveled the vastness of the astral planes and is one of the great pioneers when it comes to astral travel. And then one day he met an entity with whom he spoke about the creation of the Earth. And the interesting thing is that this entity then said, "Oh, your information that you gave me contradicts my information and I'll give you my information that I have about the Earth." And that's where it got interesting, because he was able to register with this information that the Earth was built by a gardener. First tried that with dinosaurs to produce Loosh. Loosh is a term. It's a bit abstract, of course, because you don't really know what to do with it. But you can actually use anything for Loosh, energy or awareness or love. So you can use anything for this term, Loosh. And it was important to the gardener to build a garden that would enable a high production of Loosh. And for this purpose he created living beings so that these living beings produce Loosh. And this Loosh that was produced was derived via so-called Loosh pipelines. The out-of-body experiences among us may be familiar with these Loosh pipelines, namely these tunnels of light. Yes, and that's how the Loosh is transported away. You can perhaps imagine that, statistically speaking, a person dies every 3 seconds every day. How many people die there in one day? And in this respect, one can imagine how many thousands of souls are flying towards the light. And the moment they fly towards the light, they are purified, they say, or cleaned or whatever. They remember their whole life and regret many things they have done and want to live a much better life in the next life. And yes, and during this purification process the smack is extracted and carried away into the higher astral planes via these light tunnels. Who might not be familiar with it yet? We made a video about the light trap. These are these tunnels of light. These are these pipelines. And this is how the energy that a person has accumulated over the course of their life is transported away. And as we all know, a lot of energy is produced. And care is always taken to ensure that duality is maintained, for example. And that generates a lot of energy. All strife, discord, everything that is sown creates energy. Yes, and this Loosh energy is used or applied on the higher levels. And when Monroe, of course, then received this information from the entity, he was depressed for months because he had a positive or a light-filled, energetic, loving world view, also of the whole astral plane. and then suddenly had to realize that he was a bit something misjudged.
Auch von den ganzen Astralebenen und musste dann plötzlich feststellen, dass so ein bisschen das falsch eingeschätzt hatte.
And he didn't feel like astral travel anymore. Yes, for a long time he didn't produce any out-of-body experience at all, until at some point he said to himself, well, we can't do anything directly with this Lusch.
Wir können ja direkt mit diesem Lusch nichts anfangen.
And he then compared this Lusch, which they produce or absolutely want to have, with a cow that just gives milk. And the cow itself can't do anything with the milk either. Then he explained, we know from our dissociation videos that this is not true, hopefully. We can very well do something with this energy. And so save your energy. The Lusch is also known in the free universe. Exactly, it is used for very, very many things and on all possible levels, i.e., dimensional levels. It is used for many, many things. For example, to power spaceships, for the beings of light and their cities of light. Yes, energy is used for everything. It's like money here. Money is also a form of energy, except that our energy is manifest. And up there it is not manifest. It is energy and it is massively traded and used and utilized. And we are the farm planet, so to speak, and we are the cows. I'm sorry to tell you this, but you're a cow. Yes, you can imagine it like this. Well, there are many matrix planets. We have already talked about them in our video, Three Ways Out of the Matrix, for example, or in the video, The Map of the Matrix. We talked about the fact that this is not just about the Earth, which is a matrix planet, but there are umpteen matrix planets. I myself have seen thousands of these planets on my travels. And all these planets were built for that very purpose. Life on this planet, the system on this planet, has been set up precisely to be able to produce this sloppy stuff. And as Shiva says, Lusch can actually be compared symbolically with money on our planet. And here on our planet, everyone works to always have enough money, to have a roof over their heads, to be able to afford food and drink and maybe a trip to a restaurant or to the cinema. And all people are working towards that, so that they know that their basic needs are covered. And that's why all people somehow always try to have money so that they can make ends meet. But it goes even further, because in our world money is also misused for power. Yes, and that is also the case in other dimensions, namely with Loosh, for example. There are also different forms of Loosh. The purest Lusch, for example. What is the purest Lusch? Of course, that is selfless action, altruistic action. Most of the Lusch that is actually produced is at the moment where, for example, a mother would throw herself in front of her children to protect the children and would sacrifice her own life. You know that from movies. The villain shoots the hero with a bow and arrow and his lover throws herself in between and she gets the arrow. And those are the moments when the most Lusch is really released. One also speaks here of the so-called death clairvoyance. Have you ever heard the term? No? Death clairvoyance means the person who is dying suddenly changes from a bad guy to a good person. He forgives everyone because he sees death coming. And then he regrets what he has done in his life and things like that. And that's where the purification begins. And this purification produces an improbably large amount of Loosh. I just saw something. There are huge Lusch factories. I just saw them. So that's what came to my mind. There are huge lollipop factories. Yes. and in those lollipop factories. I don't know why I've seen this now, but maybe so it can be told in this video. They are huge camps. And in these camps the Loosh is kept and it's not even really used. So yeah, it's used and given out and sold and there's something in return for that, but most of the junk is stashed away and I think it's just really about power. As I have just, we also have symbols from the film industry here, for example the film, Jupiter Ascending, which was made by the same directors as The Matrix by the Wachowski brothers. In fact, there is obviously something to a lot of films, and not only can we say that, Monroe saw it too. And we're not the only ones who saw something like that. And if many have already seen it, independently of each other, there must be something to it. Just it. So many screenwriters, including the Wachowski brothers, who of course always discuss the screenplay and try to design the film, etc. Did a lot of research, also for The Matrix, for example, and Jupiter Ascending. Those are the two biggest films they made, where they really did a lot of research on a spiritual level. She talked to monks, talked to people who were spiritually very well developed, talked to people who called themselves enlightened and were able to gather their knowledge. And Jupiter Ascending is also about that substance being collected there because you can do anything with that substance. They even traded planets with it. Or solar systems. Yes, that's right, you can see that too. They did really good research and there are quite a few things. It's not fantasy. No, it is quite a reality. In the free universe and on the 4D plane. On the 4D level you can always find extraterrestrials trading there with Lusch. And this Lusch also appeared symbolically in the film, Dune der Wüstenplanet. Ah yes, yes. In the film there are three houses that are at odds with each other over a desert planet. And on this desert planet exist gigantic worms that are kilometers long. And these worms produce something called spice. And this spice, they just separate and it is then harvested in the desert by harvesters and then they transport the spice to storage and hoard it there. And with this spice you can expand your consciousness and power spaceships. Haha. Look at one. And that's also a symbolic correspondence, because the screenwriters don't always really know what it's about or don't necessarily have a clue, but they have intuition. That means the ideas, the creative, intuitive ideas that come to a screenwriter. And I'm a writer myself. I've already published several books, so I know it too. There are moments when you don't really know what to do next. And then suddenly creative, intuitive ideas come to you. It also means inspiration from the spiritual world into your head. Correct? Yes, exactly. And this Lusch is also traded in the free universe. And as Shiva says, they power everything with it. Or they can also expand their consciousness with it, can acquire skills with it and an end. So it's a kind of form of energy that you can use and it's extremely sought after. But who are the biggest Lusch producers? I was just about to address that. I know. The gods, the real ones anyway. Yes, the gods. And therefore planets are also traded. They say, here I have a planet. Well, let's take Earth as an example. Earth is a planet with an incredible number of gods sitting on it, all of whom have amnesia. They all have no idea what's going on. Memory is erased, they can't remember anything. but they are still the biggest Loosh producers because they have much, much more energy, because they came from the original source. In contrast to all the planets that have been created in the universe. As the word implies, they were created. So they do not have their own divine energy, but they have this divine energy or energy. The gods created the matter there with the help of this enormous divine energy. And of course these planets can't produce this Lusch per se, but it has to come from, living beings is the wrong term, but it has to come from gods, this energy. From divine beings. And many of us, including those watching right now, could very well be divine beings. If you don't remember your lives, if you don't know your real name, if you don't know where you came from, you suffer from amnesia. And, yes, you're probably asking yourselves now, how is the lollipop production fueled here on our planet? Or maybe, if you can protect yourself from it or something. And of course we want to talk about that for a moment, I would say. And let's start with how this is going to be fueled, sort of. We already mentioned it shortly before. Our planet is based on polarity, our whole belief system on duality. And yes, you can do a lot with it. Yes, in any case, so in order to increase the production of pleasure on a planet, conflicts would actually have to be spread by an invisible government. Yes, I can imagine that happening here too. Yes, I can also imagine that this has happened here before. Yes, maybe very up to date. And the Lusch production is spurred on by the fact that there is a lot of quarreling, a lot of resentment, power struggles, different opinions, where people almost go at each other's throats because the other has a different opinion. Religious wars. Oh God, yes. What do you think is produced there? Well, these are the biggest wars that have prevailed for thousands of years and are still and still prevailing. Even yes, killing in the name of a god or sowing discord. And yes, and no one is better than the others. I mean, the church always says it's peaceful, but what they've done in the past is a whole range of events or actions that were really, really violent. One has to think of the Crusaders or the witch hunts or the Conquista, etc. etc. So it starts in the Viking Age and before that. Yes, exactly, the fight between the Danes, the Vikings and the English and so on, where the story was also rotated a bit and so and then you notice all these conflicts. You belong to this group and you belong to this group, you belong to this nation and you belong to this nation, is the best breeding ground for conflicts, groups and countries. Different languages too or different cultures. One culture condemns the other and vice versa. So you can see that everything is really material for possible conflicts. And where did it start then? In the creation between man and woman back then? Well, you know, you remember with the Anunnaki then creating male and female. What produces more discord than the separation between male and female? Yes, gender struggle and in general. Yes, battle of the sexes. Yes, in any case. Men and women always attract each other somehow. Of course, because they have been split from the core into a male and a female side. And sure, the core wants to exist again and so male and female attract and try to connect over and over again. And of course there are also many groups that create conflicts between men and women. I can also explain why Soros created feminism. Yes, correct. Yes, good example. Yes or? Yes, race struggles? Yes. Black and white man-woman. So you know what we're getting at. The entire programming to be able to generate conflicts at all takes place via the media. For example, predominantly via the media and thus automatically also via thinking. Yes, programming is distributed through the media, through general knowledge, as the saying goes. That's where the programming is distributed. Some then think, ah, I'm a black man, I have to fight for my rights now. Then there are white people who say, ah, I have to fight for my children. And so it just goes on, and the groups quarrel with each other. And of course, that can lead to riots or attacks. Someone walks into a store with a bomb and everything explodes. You see, it's always about struggle, inner struggle, outer struggle. And in this regard, of course, people are always manipulated through thought. Yes, but luckily we have a solution. Yes, and of course we have a solution, dissociation. And with that you even store energy in yourself. Correct. Because that's what it's about. Sure, you are always Lusch producers on this planet, on a matrix planet. You can't get around it, but you can keep or store your energy through dissociation, so to speak, and it is not released to any other place at the moment. Well, each of us gods, let me tell you, we are actually gods who are prevented. Indisposed. Because we all suffer from amnesia and no one remembers his true inner PSI abilities or his own creative abilities, and Loosh producer is therefore every god. That's why planets are so coveted in the universe that have gods as residents. And the more gods a planet has as inhabitants, the more valuable the planet is. Because then, of course, the Lusch factory is also at its highest. The highest efficiency. And the only option you have is dissociation, because dissociation first distances us from our programming, how we are programmed, from our beliefs, as the saying goes, from our convictions. Because gods all have one thing in common, because their creative power still acts subconsciously, I'll say it now. Amnesia can only prevent the respective god from being able to consciously access his abilities. However, the ability still acts in a stealth or subliminal manner, so to speak. So this means that each god creates his own reality. Who else? Everyone creates their own reality based on their creative ability. Of course, just because the amnesia is prevalent and you can't remember it, there are a lot of problems. Unfortunately, one does not create consciously. One does not create consciously, and therefore one does not understand that what is in one's everyday reality is itself created. One does not understand it, because one is not aware of the creative power. And that's why you can't imagine that you created it all yourself, because you don't understand it. And does not see. First of all, dissociation ensures that you distance yourself from your thoughts and, of course, from your programming, from your beliefs, which you absolutely believe are true. And through the dissociation, energy is held back, and this energy then builds up, and with the dissociation energy one can then regain access to one's abilities, or rather see things in everyday life that others do not see. You can activate your pineal gland, do astral travel, dream lucidly. All of this is possible with this energy. And that is why one understands the double meaning of Lusch production. Firstly, the gods should produce Lusch, and secondly, because they think so much and give off so much energy during their lifetime, they do not. Have enough energy to expand their consciousness. So at this point I would just like to recommend Jonathan's book again. Spiritual dissociation is really the master technique, our superhero ability as you say. And it's just true on its own. If you dissociate for 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes, you can already feel the energy in your body. You can feel the body vibrating from within. You notice how the energy is collected and stored. If you really want to come back to yourself, use the dissociation and all the techniques and possibilities and whatever you can think of are described in your book. Therefore, it is definitely worth it. Yes, in any case. And yes, as I said, you can use this energy yourself, so to speak. So far you've only been producers giving off the energy to higher levels, to the deep, deep state or whatever you want to call it. You release this energy, and through dissociation one can learn to keep this energy for oneself and to store it, so to speak. Because who are the producers? That's us, the amnesia gods, you could say. Well, gods, maybe that's a bit of an example. Calling yourself a god always sounds so pompous. But we are creator beings. Yes, that's a good word. Creator beings. Creator beings who have incredible energy. But that energy is diverted. And that's why it's important that we learn to use this energy ourselves. For those who are not yet familiar with the subject, we recommend the books by Robert Monroe, who has written a great deal about out-of-body experience. Otherwise, check out the movie Jupiter Ascending. There it is also represented symbolically with the Lusch, or Dune, the desert planet, as mentioned. And otherwise, we can only refer to our videos. Videos about dissociation. Videos about the Matrix, the light trap. Exactly. Take a look. If you don't know that yet, then you will also understand the larger context that is taking place here. Because we are not alone in the universe and there are umpteen Matrix planets, all of which are used in exactly the same way as our Matrix planet. Exactly. And as I said, the greatest production takes place at the end of life, when you die. And we wouldn't be the Matrixers if we didn't say, out of the Matrix. Yes, out of the Matrix, because then that energy can't be taken away from you at the end of your life when you leave the Matrix. Three ways out of the Matrix, one of our videos. Check it out. It is so, Shiva. So we hope that you understood the Lusch theme that way, but we strongly assume that our viewers will know immediately what is being played here, what is going on here. And we hope that more and more viewers will see the bigger picture, because we can only put out one video at a time, and that video is one piece of the puzzle, and then we'll put out another video, another piece of the puzzle. But it's important to put all those pieces of the puzzle together and see the big picture. Only then can you see through the whole system, beginning with the so-called history that we have all learned, spanning to what is happening on Earth that is happening in recent years and is happening now. And further, how this all has to do with lucid dreams, astral travel, how this all has to do with extraterrestrials, with UFOs, how this all has to do with other planets, with other Matrix planets, how this has to do with the astral planes and so on. It's all connected. Everything. It all hangs on a string, and that's important to recognize. And why is it important to recognize? So that we can step out of the game, even while we are alive, step out of the duality to become who you really are again. Yes. Put simply. And we're just trying to help people, to give them tips, to give techniques, to make sure that you recognize and rediscover dissociation as your superhero ability and then of course use it.
Und natürlich dann auch einsetzt.
And dissociation. Go ahead, folks, and don't be dissuaded. The mind can come up with something. Yes, and you just have to resist a bit and everything will be fine. Oh well. Yes, do you have anything else to say? On the exciting topic about Lusch energy, matrix, planets, spaceships that are powered with it, and what do I know? Lusch factory? Actually, yes, but you said the video was going to be too long and I completely... That's why we're breaking up. No, we've said the most important thing and I think you can relate to it and I'm sure we'll find all your questions in the comments. If we do a live video again, you can of course also ask questions. Yeah, right. As I said, you can write your questions in the comments if you have any. Otherwise, we will of course continue to make videos. And yes, we hope to see you again next time. We hope you had fun and were able to take a little something with you. And don't despair. Ask Shiva and Jonathan. Until next time, dear ones, take care and goodbye.